Hi everyone, welcome back to Selah as we journey through Lent together. On Wednesdays we've been exploring the spiritual discipline of fasting. In last week's episode we chatted about embracing weakness. My experience of fasting this week has probably been defined by weakness. Now I've managed to avoid watching pasta videos and resisted buying my weight in penne and feta. But spiritually, emotionally and physically, I found this week pretty tough going. I've been ill and tired and grumpy. I haven't really spent quality time with God, and I've had anxious thoughts creeping up on me. Not really things that you'd think of as a great recipe for baking a spiritual discipline cake, but let me tell you one story. On the Wednesday just gone, or at least the one that's just gone at the time of putting this episode together, I was rated on to lead worship at the House of Prayer. However, I wasn't feeling myself. I had a bit of a throat infection, and probably shouldn't have been singing really, which is what I found out. My voice completely went about 35 minutes into a two-hour set, but thankfully the rest of the team stepped up. Someone else took over the singing and I could continue to just play guitar. We somehow made it through and God showed up. It was an example to me of how God can take our weakest moments and demonstrate his strength, and that encountering him isn't dependent on our state or ability. All we need to do is show up and bring what we have. Although, disclaimer, if your voice is sharp, I would not recommend pushing through. It also showed me how much we need each other and the beauty of community, because we can shoulder each other's burdens, step up for and encourage one another. I've been fasting alongside someone else, and I've definitely found committing to it easier. Walking alongside others as we pursue lives lived for Jesus is what we all need.
I will stop and breathe in your presence. Just breathe, just breathe.
In today's episode, we're going to be chatting about the rewards of fasting. From previous episodes, I think we've deduced that a discipline where we restrict and deny ourselves something is not one that we're naturally drawn to. It doesn't scream of joy, and I can imagine it's not one where our first thought is naturally, oh goody, today I get to fast. But there are treasures to be found as we seek to pursue this discipline in our lives. In Matthew 6, Jesus says, "But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that it will not be obvious to others that you're fasting, but only to your Father who is unseen. And your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you." God will reward us when we fast. What could this mean? On this journey, we've explored how choosing to fast, whether we feel like it or not, positions our hearts towards God. It's a way of saying yes to him. We know from scripture that we reap spiritual rewards from choosing Jesus, that we're transformed from the inside out and taken from glory to glory. But often we don't see these changes or transformations or see ourselves as reaping the rewards of our yes until much further down the line. When we fast, regardless of how we feel, we're taking steps to be closer to him. And by nature of moving closer to God, we'll eventually begin to see our hearts and emotions become more tender and sensitive to him. We might not recognize that this is what's happening at first, but in choosing to fast, we're seeking first his kingdom and making moves to put the commandment to love God with all of our heart, mind, soul, and strength at the center of our lives. As we begin to love God more, we'll experience more of his love. Remember, we love because he first loved us. We'll behold more of his beauty as we seek him and feel his affection for us. As I said, these aren't things that we're likely to experience straight away, but as we set aside a place to fast in our lives, whatever that looks like, we'll slowly begin to see a shift and change in our desire for and experience of God and in our perspective. We've explored in fasting, and also across other disciplines we've been looking at in Lent, how restricting and denying ourselves causes our heart's desires to change. When we say no to worldly pleasures because we want to walk in step with the Spirit, the things that used to satisfy us no longer will. Our desire to walk in the way of Jesus increases. As we become more connected with him, we'll begin to see and feel things in the way that he does. We'll want to be active and not passive in our faith. We'll want to run the race for him and yearn to live holy lives as he calls us to. It doesn't mean we won't get to enjoy the good things that God has blessed us with, just that they'll begin to take their rightful place in our lives. Fasting also makes space in our lives to hear more of God. By nature, we're self-centered and our focus is often on ourselves. When we fast, we position ourselves to hear from God, to hear the truth that he's speaking over us and our lives. Fasting strengthens our spirits and our sense of identity in God. As we lean on Jesus in our weakened state, we get closer to him and further away from the voices of insecurity and the lies that try to come against and discourage us. We'll begin to hear the voice of Jesus louder in our lives and know more and more who he says that we are. And that is a better place to work from than any identity that we're trying to cobble together ourselves. And lastly, let's not forget the physical benefits of fasting. It doesn't just affect our spirits, but our bodies as well. I can have a tendency to binge on certain foods, especially bread. I seem to have a deep love of carbs here, but I'm trying to exercise more self-control and doing physical exercise alongside it. I had a moment with God a couple of years ago where I really felt challenged by him to take better care of my body, to do as much as I could to steward my body so that that would never get in the way of what God was calling me to do. Overindulging in excess can dull our spirits as well as make us feel physically rubbish long term. When we fast, we restrict ourselves. Our minds and spirits become sharper towards the things of God and strip away our idols. Our physical bodies have a chance to reset and get rid of toxins our bodies don't need. Fasting gives our digestive system a break and allows our bodies to heal. Fasting gives us a chance to see where we might be overindulging or dependent on foods or things like caffeine and show us where we need to make changes to our diet. Now, if you've got serious health issues, consult with your doctor before fasting. But for the most part, it's a good tool for our physical well-being. As we enter into this final week of Lent and towards our last episode on fasting, think back on the journey so far and recognise that that's what this is. It's a journey. We don't begin and arrive at our destination all in one go. There has to be a road from A to B. It will be full of ups and downs and U-turns probably, maybe some stopping and starting, but it's all a process. And as always, as we run this race, we know that there is an abundance of God's grace and that he extends the invitation to us to draw closer to him every day.
I will run this race, and I will do it all for love. Your love compels me forward, your love controls my heart, and I cannot get away. So I will fight this good fight of faith, and I will do it all for love. You are my great reward, you're so worth fighting for, and I can't wait to see your face. So I will run, I will run this race, and I will do it all for love. Your love compels me forward, your love controls my heart, and I cannot get away. So I will fight this good fight of faith, and I will do it all for love. You are my great reward, you're so worth fighting for, and I can't wait to see your face. I can't wait your face. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.